I promised you a few videos about certain rituals that you can do. It's about what kind of rituals you can think of when you're in a long distance dynamic. So my master is living in a different country than me. There is a sea between us. It means that we have to fly to see each other. And that sucks nowadays. I haven't seen him in like forever. And I don't even know when I'm gonna see him again. So all the time my flights got cancelled. My master put some rituals in place. They change for us. They're not always the same. And sometimes they're different because we're working towards something. For instance, he always makes me different rituals. As soon as we know that we're gonna see each other again, usually like 50 days before or 30 days before or a week before, it depends on how long it will take. And it depends on, of course, what kind of ritual he makes. I just would like to share with you a few ideas on what kind of rituals you could create for your dom-sub relationship. This is specifically for long distance relationships. I'm going to make a different one on rituals when you're living together. I think probably quite a few of them you can also use for living together, but these are specifically for when you're in long distance. The biggest, most important ritual for us is my journaling. That is always there. That's the only ritual that's not changing. And I think it's so important because for us, it's creating a connection. It forces us to connect with each other, to communicate with each other, to communicate with each other every day. And that's why for us, it's so important. There's a different video about journaling. So please watch that if you want to know more about how to do that, how to incorporate that into your relationship and how to make it help your relationship to thrive. The next thing is find something that your submissive can do every day. There's different rituals. It might also be that there is a ritual that they have to do every week. Right now I'm looking for rituals that you have to do every day. The rituals can be sexual, can be non-sexual. I have one assignment or one ritual right now. I have it and it's meant to have every day. And it means I have to edge every day. And my master told me to buy a calendar so I could put them down, the times that I edge. And so I can see how many times I edged. And also I can put something else in it as soon as I come. So whenever I have an orgasm. So I know that I could buy a calendar, but first of all, it would take me time because the stores are closed here. So I couldn't just go and pick one up. And also I kind of liked it to make one myself. So I brought it. It's quite, I'm a masochist and we're in a master-slave relationship. So it might seem that it doesn't fit, but I had some kind of little space and I created a calendar. You can have a look here. It was a wonderful way for me to put all my love in it and to, well, channel it somehow, I guess. So all I'm doing is every day I'm going at the end of the day, I'm going on my knees, it's hanging on eye level, and I'm going to fill in the amount of edges that I did that day. Yeah, my another ritual that I have that pretty much always, but as you know, I have two little kids, so sometimes when they're with me, I'm not sleeping on my leash, but sleeping on a leash is one of my sleeping rituals. Sometimes my master gives me more like the assignment, like the one thing. And then he tells me that I have to wear a plug in the night or I have to sleep on my belly with my legs spread or wearing a tail or similar things like that. There was one time that we knew that we were going to see each other again. And he let me sleep for a week with my hands tied on my back. I know shackles that I can unlock them myself, but still it's very uncomfortable to do it like this. And the fun thing is it showed me that even that I could learn to do. So at one point I did. Of course there are other sleeping rituals as well. If you have a little, it's wonderful to have them sleep with a stuffed animal. I brought the stuffed animal. It's a really awesome one. Look at this. Ah. But there are different sleeping rituals. For instance, you could have the your submissive sit on her knees and thank you for the day before she hops into bed, for instance. So there's a few things. I really like rituals that are connected to the daily things that you have to do anyway. For instance, brushing your teeth. That's another idea. Whenever she's brushing her teeth or he's brushing his teeth, for instance, he tell them that they have to do it naked. And also that after brushing their teeth, let them take a minute, stand in front of the mirror, and say, for instance, a certain sentence that you tell them that they have to say. For instance, your master loves you, you're beautiful, and you're going to make the best of your day today. Or I'm, and then that's what they have to say is, I'm beautiful, my master loves me, and I'm going to make a, I'm going to make my day epic. And what you can create the sentence that you want that fits for you and that you would love to have your submissive. It's a wonderful exercise anyway, especially if they're a little bit low on self-esteem, but even if they're not, it's just a wonderful way to communicate whatever you think about them and how you want them to make them feel. Yeah, another one. I don't get that like every day, but for now I'm getting it. I'm having it for 28 days. I have to send my master every day a sexy picture. And it has to be of, I need to pick out one thing that is very sexy and I have to wear it and then I need to make a video out of it for it. So I'm going to show you in a minute how that looks because I'm wearing something really sexy today. And I made my master, of course, I made them a video or a picture with it. For rituals, you don't have to do every day the same ritual. What you could do is you can use an app for it. And I really like this app. It's called Spin the Wheel. And it looks like a Wheel of Fortune. What it does is it's just a Wheel of Fortune. And you can just add like 5 or 6 or 12 different things that they have to do. For instance, when I had a very, very masochistic period and I really, really needed the pain, my master made me a wheel of pain that had 100 hits on your pussy, 100 hits on your breast, and 100 hits, and then with different impact. I just had to turn the wheel, and I had to do that. It was like costing me 5 minutes. I had to do that every day when the kids were not with me. And so it was a ritual, but it was deferring, which is good for me because I get bored if I have to do like 2 years the same thing again, except for the journaling. So that's a great way to find a ritual that you can actually change a bit with it. And you could do that, for instance, with clothing as well. You could just put in the wheel, you can put stilettos, sexy panties, no panties, a sexy bra, no bra, mini skirt, whatever you want. And then they just have to turn the wheel. And that is what they're going to wear today. So it could help you. So because you don't have to pick every day their clothes, but it will be based on what the wheel is saying. But it's a lot of fun because it's actually telling them what to do. And this is brilliant. And you can play with it. There are so many options. Once you have that wheel, I'm going to put the link to where you can download the app also in the description below. So you can find it and you can use it for yourself. I think this is fantastic. For a long distance relationship, this is fantastic. Another one is I have 2 different colors. I have one for the day and one for the night. I also have a play one that's even different. But then, of course, when we're playing or when I am playing, there is already a ritual for it. But you could, if you have this for the color, or your submissive has a collar that she cannot wear whenever she's taking a bath or a shower, like mine. I don't want to wear this when I'm showering. It gets black very quickly. So I'm taking it off and you can add a ritual to it. For instance, you can only put on your collar after you're sitting on your knees and you're getting into your submissive space. And only then you thank me that I'm willing to collar you. And then you can put on your collar. This kind of rituals. It's very easy to find something that fits for you, but at least you have an idea on where you can play with. Another thing that's fantastic and you can use all kinds of different rituals with it is you have alarms on your telephone. Everyone has it. put an alarm for a specific time in the day. You can decide what time of day, because, well, especially if you know each other a little bit more better, then you know what is a good time anyway. For instance, the time for us, for me, well, it depends on where I am and what I'm doing, but usually in the evenings, at 8 o'clock, it's always for me a good time if the kids are not here. There's a huge difference for me because the kids are there and kids are not there. But when the kids are not there, 8 o'clock is always a good time. And my master tells me to put my alarm clock on a specific time, and then he lets me do something. For instance, edging. It can also be that I have to send him a message. It can be that I have to do my affirmations. It can be that I have to do... It can be that I have to undress and I have to do 20 jumping jacks and send him a video of my bouncing boobies because he loves bouncing boobies. Who doesn't, huh? It depends. But just realize that actually having an alarm is sending a message to your submissive at that moment. This is a wonderful time to do something for me, and it will create a lot of connection. So it will take them out of their daily life. So it's not for everyone, but maybe it's something that you can use as well. Yeah. There's one that I just made for myself. He doesn't know, but I thought it might also be a really nice message, but I'm creating it for his birthday. I'm having a diary, but besides the diary, I'm writing him a love letter, and I'm writing him one sentence every day. It's on my list, one sentence every day. And that's a wonderful, because I think after a year, I'll probably have a fantastic book with 365 love letters of one sentence. And I think that's wonderful. Now you have a little bit more ideas on what kind of rituals you could do for your submissive, especially when you're in a long distance relationship. I love long distance relationships. It gives so much creativity to create connection. Please, 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 if you have amazing rituals yourself, just put them in the comments below, because I would love to read them, and we can learn from each other. Link is down below. Have fun and play with passion.